Welcome to everybody. Today is really an exceptional date for us because here we have the first presentation of the data collected by an extraordinary project, which is Planck. This is a project that started more than 21 years ago. It is a major enterprise of the cost of about 800,000 euros, and that involved 400 physicists, technicians, engineering, and so on and so forth. Is also is not only an international project, but is also a project where Italy, together with France, are the two protagonists, and within Italy, Trieste plays a major role. So it's really something that really makes us very proud of hosting this event today here, because is an essential, a concrete demonstration of the capacity of Italian science and technology to be at the frontier of science and technology in the world. So we expect a big result. We expect to have answers to many of the open questions in physics, astrophysics and astroparticles today. And with that, I believe my speech is even too long. But I have to say something more. We have today the honor to have also honorable, I don't know how to translate that in English, Serracchiani. And I believe that this is also, I mean, she's visiting several scientific institutions in the region, and is also a way to demonstrate the attention that Honorable Serracchiani has for scientific research and high education. And so we cannot be but very happy of her presence here, and she will probably address some words to the audience. So, please, Honorable Serracchiani.
Thank you very much. Let me address those of you who are not native Italians with a special greeting in English. Since I know that more or less 30% of you are come from foreign countries, it's a great honor to welcome you to this remarkable scientific event. It is also a pleasure to confirm the excellence of this city, this land, their scientific institutions. Let me continue in Italian now. Thank you very much. È per me un onore, oltre che un piacere, essere qui oggi con voi. Per rivolgervi questo indirizzo di saluto in occasione della presentazione di un progetto così prestigioso come il progetto Planck. Ed è particolarmente un onore per me essere qui in un luogo che è un luogo di eccellenza, il cuore dell'eccellenza. Mi fa piacere rivolgervi questo saluto, anche perché questa eccellenza è fatta dalla generosità di tante persone che dedicano interamente la loro vita alla ricerca, che spesso è poco valorizzata nel nostro paese. Ed è ancora di più un onore perché lo faccio da Trieste, lo faccio da questa regione, del Friuli Venezia Giulia, che se vuole essere appunto una regione a vocazione internazionale deve investire di più nella ricerca scientifica, nella buona ricerca scientifica. Naturalmente quella buona ricerca scientifica i cui risultati non sono proclamati o autoproclamati, come accade spesso nel nostro paese, ma che trovano riconoscimento oggettivo, come oggi, come in questo caso, sul piano internazionale. Senza dubbio la SISSA è un'istituzione che fa buona ricerca, come dimostrano i grants internazionali e nazionali che sono riconosciuti ai ricercatori, e fa parte del cosiddetto sistema Trieste della ricerca, ed è per questo che rivolgo il mio saluto anche ai ricercatori dell'Università di Trieste, dell'Osservatorio Astronomico e dell'ICTP, che so essere in sala. Se c'è, devo dire, anche dalla mia esperienza di parlamentare europeo, un luogo che non c'è bisogno di essere presentato quando si ha a che fare con persone che fanno parte della comunità scientifica, è proprio Trieste. commentavo prima con il direttore che in quel mondo non c'è bisogno di presentare Trieste, non c'è bisogno di presentare il Friuli Venezia Giulia, fuori dalla comunità scientifica quando si dice che si viene da Trieste bisogna spiegare che è vicino Venezia. E quindi credo che sia un segnale assolutamente, come dire, positivo della buona ricerca e degli obiettivi raggiunti e anche dell'eccellenza della SISA. Io mi permetto solo di fare un'osservazione. Se così è, vuol dire che bisogna investire di più nella ricerca, farlo come chiede l'Europa, fino al 3% del nostro PIL. Io penso che debba farlo anche la regione Friuli Venezia Giulia, e a questo proposito devo rilevare che è una regione che deve prestare maggiore attenzione. Questo è l'anno in cui il prelievo fiscale è particolarmente forte, lo è ad esempio per l'IMU, lo è ad esempio per l'IRAP, che viene richiesto al sistema universitario in una misura pari al doppio di quella che viene chiesta per banche finanziarie in questa regione. Quindi credo che ci voglia un'attenzione maggiore. È inutile fare normative regionali con cui diamo pochi spiccioli alle università e al sistema universitario e poi chiederne indietro tanti di più con il prelievo fiscale. Quindi credo che ci vogliano degli impegni anche chiari che vadano in questa direzione. Quindi io mi auguro e spero che di poter operare in questa direzione insieme appunto ad un sistema di eccellenza che serve anche per il progresso non solo della comunità scientifica ma della nostra comunità regionale. Quindi desidero ringraziare il direttore per questa occasione, tutti voi professori, docenti, ricercatori, dottorandi e studenti, e augurarvi ovviamente buon lavoro oggi per la presentazione del progetto. Grazie.
So since, you know, here in Trieste, plan collaboration involves two major institutes. The third one is actually the university, but the two major institutes involved in the collaborations are CIS and the ICT, and ICTP1, and ENAF. I guess I should say a few words about the role of ENAF, that ENAF, and in particular the Observatory of Trieste, played in this collaboration. I think it's amazing, actually, that Trieste really demonstrated to play such a big role in such a big and important collaboration that is producing really a breakthrough in the understanding of the universe. Maybe most of you followed over the last weeks or the press releases and announcement of the results by Planck. If I think back in the old days when I was a PhD student myself here at CISA, I remember when back in 92, Dennis Sciama coming back from a conference announced to the students that the first detection of the quadrupole of the CMB anisotropies were announced by the COBE collaboration at that time, okay? And as a student, you know, I was a student that has grown up with the, you know, with the upper limits in the CMB anisotropies. As the experiments were improving and improving, these upper limits were going down and down, down to an embarrassing level, okay? So when we discovered, when the people discovered from Planck that there was actually a level of CMB anisotropies announced at the level actually expected from the standard cosmological model, it was a sort of shock for several of us because we were, you know, just in front of what we thought was just an elegant model with predicted power, but, you know, we were kind of skeptical. We'd grown up with some skepticism about this issue of, you know, inflation, cold dark matter, and things like that. So it was really a shock for us. And it's actually really amazing that now, with Planck, it's not just discussing whether there are or not anisotropies, whether or not we are confirming a standard cosmological models, but we are really putting constraints on the detailed knowledge of the universe, okay? And this is really amazing. It's really amazing that has been reached with such a big contribution from the Trieste community. And I think that the Trieste community is not just finishing its job with the Planck collaboration. We are already working for the next big enterprise, which is the Euclid collaboration, okay? And this is great because this means that the collaboration established between, between CISA and Observatory of Trieste, also involved in the university, and now also the ICTP more and more, it's actually building a sort of system of Trieste for the research in cosmology, in physics in general, but in this particular case of cosmology. So it's just, you know, I look to the future with a lot of optimism, despite the boundary condition of the country, for what we can do here in Trieste for basic science that I agree with Honorevole Serracchiani need to be founded at a stronger level than has been done so far. Thank you very much to all of you, and I look forward to the talks.
Okay, now we proceed to the presentations, which are divided in sections, and they are designed to give you a sort of overview of the contribution of Trieste. So the first speaker is Professor Luigi Danese, which was former Vice Director at CISA, and together with Professor Gianfranco Rizzotti, which is on the first row, was one of the first proposer of a powerful satellite, just after the first discovery of structures in the cosmic microwave background.
Morning, and let me give you a brief historical view of the Planck in Trieste and myself in particular in CISA. I guess then Fabio will give the view from the observatory point of view, let's say. And let's say that the interest started in CMB in what was at the beginning the Palo Observatory and CISA group started in 1973. So I don't know how to make the calculations, but anyway, some years ago, and with Gianfranco in particular, myself, working on the theoretically on doing theoretical work on spectrum CMB. Then we have been contacted by George Smoot in 1978, and we started with him and a group of Italians, people, experimental people, observation on the CMB spectrum. Then, let's say, as mentioned by the COBE mission clearly showed that it was possible to go into details and measure the anisotropy of the cosmic microwave background radiation. And we started in particular in 1991, I think, Gianfranco, I don't remember if it's the right, more or less, anyway. It was an idea of Gianfranco, who was in that time in the science committee of ESA, to start to think about the CMB beyond, in particular the CMB and anisotropy beyond COBE. And then we discussed with Mandolesi, who was at that time interested in this kind of observations, and we started to think about the first setup of the satellite, let's say 1.5 meters radio, working there with radio receivers and so on. We started to contact again the Wilkinson and George Smoot, asking them if the project was particularly stupid or not. They were extremely encouraging from this point of view, and then we start to presenting at ESA the project. The name was COBRAS, Cosmic Microwave Background Anisotropies, a study started the more or less 1992. On the same time, on the same subject, but with a different technology, with bolometers, a project called SAMBA was presented by the French people, led by Jean-Luc Piget. After discussion, papers, as you may imagine, in 1996, he's approved the Planck mission, in which cobras plus samba together means LFI, what is now LFI plus HFI, and there was a commitment by ASDI to fund the Italian effort. And in 1998, they started the mission, let's say the concrete realization of the mission. Of course, in Italy, the problem was, as it is usual the case, the problem of attracting people and money, or even because the CMB community at that time was relatively small, and practically a few individuals, 20 in 80s. In Italy, there were three experimental groups, one in Rome, in Melchiori de Bernardis, one in Bologna, Mandolesi, in Milano, Sironi Bersanelli, one theory group, practically Gianfranco and myself. So we were minor groups in the astro and the physics areas, and the initial phases of the study was poorly supported. However, the life did not become better after the decision, because we passed several crises, and you know, the problem was that in fact, let me say that this is a problem of timing in Italy sometimes, okay? So the consensus on Planck mission is at the top now, unfortunately. And we have now more support now than then. So anyway, we endured and we are here, fortunately. However, I have to say that in the mid of 90s, a very good signal came from CISA. Amati, Sciama, Petrov, and other colleagues asked for a brief review on the Planck project soon after I arrived in CISA. At the end, they were extremely supportive. And encouraged by this attitude, we tried to involve the group in Trieste. The group which had experience on data handling, the interest for the CMB was lower there because of historical reason. Nevertheless, after some discussion, we got an additional very good signal support, and you heard by Fabio about that. We had also the contribution of the university by Anna, who was extremely important for us, and thus at the end, let's say, of the past century, okay, the team theory and data analysis was in Trieste was set up, and with the responsibility in particular of handling the LFI data. The support of CISA has been extremely strong, in particular in helping hiring people as staff or in long-term position. I remember Giancarlo, Cigalupi, Joachim, Gonzalez Nuevo, Samuel, Francesca Perotta. They are listed simply in alphabetical order. The success for the CISA contribution really is due to their enthusiasm, to their efficiency, to their skills. I should add also, as practically a team member of CISA, Gianfranco, and he really is the person who gave us an invaluable contribution, no doubt about that. Let's say that we have to thank also the general staff of CISA, which supported us during this period. I simply remember some hours spent with the administrative people trying to understand what we could do in order to repair the problems generated by the bureaucracy tasks and so on. So that's thanks to everybody. We had also a contribution from Region and Trieste funds for computing, and we have also to acknowledge that. Important for CISA is the fact that we had six postdocs dedicated. Here I list some of the most recent ones. A couple of them are still are present here, and a few of them just moved in the last few years. And again, extremely important for CISA has been the contribution by students. Really, this has been an important training for students, and most of them, of these students, are still in the consortium, and possibly I missed somebody, but I apologize, but I think that this is the... We have to also to thank ASI for the financial support, even if with some intermittence, okay, there's some going up and down, and lack of continuity. However, both institutions, Observatory and CISA, gave the support during this extremely, extremely hard period. As you will hear in a few minutes, Planck has produced a superb mapping of all the sky, showing how was the young universe. And let's say that Planck confirms that the physics as we know it, it is not sufficient to describe the universe as we see it. The light coming from the young universe says that the universe is dark. Okay, so we have that most of the universe, we call most of the universe as dark. Okay, that's the point. Dark means that we don't know, not that it is dark at all, but we don't know. And in fact, we see a lot of electromagnetic radiation reaching us from remote galaxies, quasars, radio galaxies, so on. Such astrophysical objects map the universe and its evolution. I recall, just to recall here, the interesting fact that on the same rocket, the ESA launched the same rocket of Planck. They launched also Herschel. And for us was a really terrible day, because a failure would be for us, because we are interested also in Herschel, because Herschel, for instance, produced a spectacular result casting light on the formation of galaxies in the quasars, and thus complementing the Planck view of the universe. I mentioned only one result, the spectacular result of gravitational lensing, which is opening the possibility of studying in details faraway galaxies in their components, baryons, dark matter, and to constrain the nature of dark energy. However, what next? Okay? With Planck, we still may improve in an important way the our knowledge of a randomization epoch, when the UV photons start to reionize the universe. The UV photons coming from first stars and galaxies reionize the universe. With other missions, detailed study of polarization will be possible. And what is interesting is that why 20 or 30 years ago the CMB community was a small community in Italy, now it is a well-established, well-known, and well-estimated and well-prized. However, there are also non-CMB cosmological missions, and in particular the next mission will be in which CISA Observatory and University of Trieste in a more significant way than in Planck are significantly involved is Euclid. I don't know, 10 years from now, maybe?
2020
possibly, plus minus plus something, not minus.
Plus 7 years.
Minus zero, plus something. The objectives are dark matter and dark energy. The main objective is dark matter and dark energy by mapping the galaxies and quasars in the universe. I know that the observatory already set up. The CISA team is already set up. Carlo, Bacigalupi, Bressan, Lapi, Perrotta, Salucci. Gianfranco and myself, we do what we can. It is important in CISA to keep, because of we are speaking about dark matter and dark energy, and so fundamental physics, it is important in interaction with CISA, the other CISA colleagues, in particular Liberati, Sotirio, Giulio, Romanino, and others. And I think that, that's more or less. Oh, once more, we are ready, and we go. Best wishes to you.